And now he say, go up to the mountain and die over there. Did you ever hear a story that Hashem comes to a human being and say, go to this place because you have to die there? And immediately runs there? Why Moshe didn't argue? 515 times he prayed in Parashat Vayetchanan, please let me enter Israel, don't kill me, let me enter, let me enter. Hashem said, enough. Do not add another words in this topic. You're not entering Israel. Now Hashem said to him, go to the mountain and die. Moshe should have said, can you give me a few more days to live? Because right now it's mitzvah. Hashem commanded me to go up to the mountain that I should die there. How many people commit a mitzvah when they die? No one. Only one in history. That his death was a mitzvah. Meaning a command from Hashem. Go there to die. Meaning by going there, you already fulfilling a command from Hashem. Like Hashem said, go and learn Torah. You're walking into the yeshiva, you're on the way to do mitzvah. It's unbelievable. So once Hashem said to Moshe, go to the mountain to die there, I just earned another mitzvah. From here we learn one more thing. Let's see who is clever here. What do you learn from this verse? Go up to the mountain that you should die there.
What's the reason why that's the way the same month as he was born?
Because the Gemara said that tzaddikim fulfilled their life, meaning they died the day he was born, the day he died, meaning he lived 120 years.
My wife passed away the same month as she was born, 5 weeks ago.
Unbelievable. Bemet's unbelievable. Aval, the question that I have now is, what do you learn from this that Hashem said to him, go to the mountain because you have to die over there? What do you learn from here? Two things you learn from here. One, nobody dies from natural causes. You die when Hashem says so. And where are you going to die? The Gemara say, the last day of your life, you don't have a free will anymore. You must go exactly to the location where you're supposed to die. Supposed to die in a hospital, that's where you're going to die. If it's in a car, it's in a car. If it's in your bedroom, it's in a bedroom. Meaning Hashem already decided how you're going to die, and where, and what time, and what second. Same thing when you're going to get married. If it's the right shidduch, when exactly it's going to happen, it's written on Rosh Hashanah. That on that day, I don't know, the 20th of Tishrei, at 8:35 p.m. and 21 seconds, that's when your soul will merge together with the soul of your wife. Meaning two, one soul that was divided to two, is reunited to the second. Not a second before, and not a second after. That's why sometimes the delays, unexpected delays. The rabbi is traffic, by the time he showed up, all of a sudden one of the witnesses, can they find, all kinds of things. You know, with Rav Moshe Feinstein, it was a very interesting thing. He was Mesader Kiddushin. He was the rabbi in a wedding. The chatan came to put the ring on the woman's finger, and it fell. Then I picked it up. הרי את מקודשת לי, הופ, again it fell. You know, everyone looks for it. Then people started, you know how they enter. Oh, משמיים, it's a sign that it's not a good shidduch. Right? Already you hear whispering. Then, הרי את מקודשת, third time you went in. Then someone came to him and said, Rabbi, you're not afraid that Hashem signaled to you that it shouldn't be...
It wasn't that.
He said, no. So why the ring fell twice? So because we needed two more minutes until the time was declared. Hashem was stalling it until the decree will be made. Meaning it cannot be a second before and a second after. Whatever Hashem wrote on Rosh Hashanah, I know I have two Yemenite single guys that eat by me for years. They were in Monsi for, I don't know, more than 10 years. One is around 40 and one is around 30. So 10 years they are singles. About 10 years. They come for holidays, they come for Shabbatot. Rosh Hashanah came, both of them got engaged after 10 years. Once Hashem decided, immediately, first engagement, a week later, second engagement. Why? No wonder Hashem put these two Temanim together and they were best friends also. You know? Why? We don't know the calculations of Hashem. It connects to previous lives. There's a lot of reasons. One thing we do know, that HaKadosh Baruch Hu is 100% righteous and fair.